Have you ever been fascinated by someone's collection? You've walked into a party and all of a sudden you see on a wall this group of shrunken heads and you say, oh my God, what would ever possess somebody to collect such a thing? Well, we're not going to talk about shrunken heads, but we're certainly going to talk about Emilio Pucci and just what drives someone's passion to collect Pucci.
It's not really a collection, these are just my clothes. I mean, yes, it's a collection now, but it didn't start out as being a collection. I just started to buy it to wear.
I think what drives someone to become a collector is a desire to learn about something that initially interests them.
Especially with something like Pucci, I think that people just see it and they relate to the colors, they relate to the period that it represents, the lifestyle it represents. They get kind of intrigued by all the different prints, how the designs changed over the years, you know, how maybe something earlier was more psychedelic and then went into something more, representational, floral, that sort of a thing. So I think it's really driven by passion.
And then next thing you know, you've got it in your closet, and you really like it, and you're somewhere else and you find another one. Oh my God, that's kind of like the piece that I already have, and I really like that, so I want like this, so oh, I think I have to have that. And then another piece, and then another piece.
They will find one piece, and they'll just fall in love with it, and then that kind of starts a process going.
I think it's kind of cute to say, all men want to be rich. Rich men want to be kings, and kings aren't satisfied until they own everything. So is power really in the possessing? Is it collecting, or is it an obsession?
When you start buying things that don't fit you, when you start buying maybe the same thing in like, you know, two or three different colors.
When you look around yourself and you find that you have more than you need.
You go out looking for it, and it's constantly in your consciousness, and you just go crazy for it.
And the whole sort of fun of it is you never know when that amazing piece is going to come up. I think when you start wanting to talk about serious collecting, I think it's not so much a number per se, but that it's a true representation. You have a really, you know, good representation of what that particular designer has done.
A real collection is made up of more pieces than you know you have.
First of all, because the colors and the design obviously are just so, you know, I mean, they're so recognizable, so iconic.
Pucci comes in so many different prints and so many different items, whether it's a watch or a coat or a bikini.
As soon as you see a Pucci dress, you know it's a Pucci dress. There's nothing else like it.
I think it's also really exciting to say that there is, without question, that celebrity connection to Emilio Pucci. As far back as we can go into times when Marilyn Monroe was spotted wearing them, Elizabeth Taylor coming through the airport with Richard Burton, Isaac Hayes, Lauren Bacall. There's another question that should be asked, and that is, does access lead to excess? I have to say for myself, because I'm in the business, it really does. Because I have access to something every other day. Either I'm invited to an estate, or I'm off to a flea market, or an auction in Paris, or something through New York, or Los Angeles, or my business in Toronto. So you have access to so much. So the more you're out there, the more you're out there hunting, the more access you have to it, the more excess you accumulate.